Hello everyone, we are back with one more live session of Fast and Dap, this time with a different player, a different sports person. This time we are joined by Marcus Joseph, who plays for Trinidad and Tobago, the country, and Gokulam FC. Delighted to have this conversation because he's a different person, different player. Welcome to everyone who is on the call, Satish, Vinod, Nitin, Deepak. So let me just get and see if Marcus Joseph, who plays for Gokulam FC and he's the captain of the team, joins the call. And we are going to have a half an hour discussion, which is going to be fantastic. Gokulam is obviously a club of based in Calicut. So let me see if Marcus is joining us right now. Let me see. Gokulam FC. And trying to get and see if he's joining in. This is going to be a very delightful conversation for everyone. And so, hey, hi Marcus, how are you?
Hi Vijay, how are you?
Great. Are you able to hear me well?
Yes, I can hear you.
Great. So, thank you very much, Marcus, for joining in. I know it's been difficult times with the COVID situation. Just before we start, I just wanted to give a quick background about you to all the viewers who are around. Marcus has been a phenomenal player for Trinidad and Tobago, who is which is much more well-known in India for the cricket. But they also play a lot of sports and games, and Marcus plays also for Gokulam FC. Gokulam FC is based out of Calicut, Kozhikode, down in south in Kerala. And they have had a phenomenal run this year. They obviously were part of the I-League, and they had won the Durand Cup this year, this season, which was a phenomenal achievement. I would like to thank Gokulam FC for this live. Thank you, Marcus, for being here. I mean, we at Fastnap welcome you.
No problem. Thank you very much to be here as well.
Great. Let's start off, Marcus. My first question would be, obviously, which is there in everyone's minds, including your fans at Gokulam. How difficult is the situation? I know you are away from home. Your season is over. You're waiting to get back. What's happening at your end?
My end, everything is okay. I'm trying to cope with it, you know. I miss my family a lot, so, you know, that's very difficult times. But, you know, at the end of the day, it's football and it's life. So, we did not see this coming. So, you know, you need to prepare for anything.
Fantastic. So, you're always on calls with your family back home through WhatsApp, through...
I'm always calling. They are calling me. My sons, you know, they are always calling me. They always make me laugh, always make me happy. My sisters, my brothers... Everyone, yeah.
To all your fans who are listening, being here, please let us also let them know that we will be asking questions and we will take those questions to Marcus and Marcus can answer that. So I know a lot of fans are crazy out there in Kerala about football. So please ask your questions. If it is in Malayalam, let's take it up and answer it as much as possible. Marcus, how do you keep fit now? I mean, obviously, it is a period where you're not playing football on the ground. So, how do you keep yourself fit?
You know, I wake up on mornings. So, you know, take like 40-minute jog. So, skip rope. I have a lot of weights near to my room. So, you know, I always do my little personal training.
That's great. So, how about footballing skills? Are you still taking that ball out, doing skills with football?
Yes, you know, I'm always with the ball. Every time I sleep with the ball also. So every time I'm training, I'm always juggling a ball to always keep that touch, always keep that momentum. Because, you know, I love to score goals. So you need that ball as close to you as possible. Eh?
Sure. Now that's fantastic, Marcus. So let me ask you. You come from Trinidad and Tobago, where obviously sports is a culture. And you have come to India, play for Gokulam FC. What has been the differences? When you first came to India, was it easy to adapt to the footballing culture in India?
It was a bit tough. It was because, you know, I'm away from home. It was my first season away home, so, you know, I had to develop a different mindset to adapt over in India here. But the quality of the football, it's okay. It's not as good home. You understand?
Correct.
So, you know, it's a higher level back at home. But the football and the fans in India, they love football a lot.
So it's been not so difficult. You have to make some adjustments, but you have been able to do that transition. That's what you're saying.
Yes, it wasn't that difficult, you know, because football is football anyway. So at the end of the day, you need to develop that mindset.
Mm-hmm. So you play for Kerala, and Kerala traditionally has been a powerhouse in football. In fact, I was looking at the Durand Cup, and I think the last time any team from Kerala won was probably in 90s, 97 or so, when FC Cochin did it. And 2019-20, Gokulam FC did it. Talk a little bit about the fans in Kerala. The fans in Kozhikode, Calicut.
Well, the fans, they are awesome. I can say they are always supportive of me. Anyway, I am, if I walk the streets, they're always coming. They want photo in the games. They are always cheering for me. So, you know, I love them a lot. They are very welcoming.
So I think somebody was asking, what is your opinion about Kerala football fans, Kerala people? I think Marcus has answered that question well. I think he loves the Kerala football fans. Marcus, have you picked up any Malayalam so far?
No, I did not pick up nothing really, you know.
Uh-huh.
But the boys they used to try to help me.
Yeah.
But it's just more few words, nothing much.
that's nice. Maybe a few words from you in Malayalam, if you are okay to say that, something which you know.
Maybe I can't remember right now because, you know,
that's fine.
I've been away from them. So
no, that's fine. That's fine. Fantastic. Marcus, let's also talk about a little bit about the Durand Cup win. I think it was a big triumph for Gokulam, because Gokulam has been putting in a lot of efforts to get a good football team going. And this would have been a great victory for you, right? So what made it special for you? I mean, how did the team play to that potential and win that Durand Cup?
You know, it was that special for me because, you know, my teammate, my good friend Andre Etienne, he was there with me. We roomed together. So, you know, we had a lot of talk together, you know, and saying that we came out here, you know, we need to go back home with at least something to show that we came out here to establish ourselves. So, you know, we put our mind to it and put our soul. We train hard. We give 100% in training.
Sure.
So, you know, hard work paid off.
Mm-hmm. That's nice. So, Durand Cup was one such thing that you had done incredibly well. The other one that you had a good amount of success was the tour to Bangladesh, where you really fought well, and you lost obviously the semifinals, but I think the footballing quality and level was great. How different was the experience when you played in Bangladesh?
Well, it was different for me, because, you know, I went to my country to play with my national team, but when I was on my way home, And I say home because, you know, it's my second home. So, you know, when I'm going to Bangladesh that same day that I have arrived to Bangladesh, we had game that same day, you know. So everyone was like, are you coming to play? Are you coming to join the team? And I was like, yeah, sure, I'm coming, you know, because I know I have a team that love me. They support me a lot. So, you know,
right.
They look at me, they need me to score goals, so, you know. I came, maybe they already played two, three games and done win. They already win these games already, you know. So I read second half. So, you know, that make me even enjoy the team that the way that they welcome me.
Sure.
Yeah, that was the biggest moment in Bangladesh for me.
No, fantastic. I think it talks a lot about football being a team sport. And if you have a good team in place, that makes a lot of difference. The other question I think a lot of your fans would love to ask you, and people are probably hinting at that, is you have another big team in Kerala, Kerala Blasters, right? So what would be the scoreline if Gokulam were to face off against Kerala Blasters?
You know, they will have to fear us, eh? Because, you know, Gokulam, we don't fear anyone, eh? No matter, football is football on the day. And if you make mistakes and you didn't come with your best, you know, you will get hurt. And the same for us, eh? You know, and I think this way about football all the time. Football is football on the day. And if they come and they are not 100%, you know, we will give 100% because I believe in my team, eh?
Yeah. So I think two tough teams playing in Kerala, I think the fans will be split and not decisive who to side, you know, because two strong teams, one from Cochin, one from Calicut. So obviously there will be a lot of good football involved.
Yes, a lot of football. Eh? We are looking forward. We are looking forward to see for this match.
Yeah, so, yeah.
To showcase Kela as well.
Sure. So let us. Fine, Marcus. So let me also take you now to another subject, which is football in India, right? Football in India, you have the ISL, you have I-League. Then there is a quality of football. You have a lot of foreigners playing. Do you think India has improved as a country in terms of football because you have a lot of foreigners coming and playing in the Indian football setup?
Yes, I think the football is rising. You know, there are a lot of good foreigners. There are a lot of good foreigners. So, you know, the football level is increasing for both I-League and ISL.
Correct. So, I think a lot of fans are also saying that Malabarians will always be strong. Malabarians is the word that you use for the fans of Gokulam. I think they also had a fantastic moment this year with the women's team winning the league this year. So, I think that's great. Marcus, the other question is, apart from football, okay, what else do you like in India?
I like the food, eh? I like to eat, you know, so I try my best to at least try maybe all the Indian food. Just to get accustomed, you know, because I'm not at home to say that I'm accustomed eating something at home, but you know, you have to adapt. So I think something different I do is the food. I try.
So there's a question. Somebody has asked, what food do you like the most in Kerala?
Which?
What food? What do you like to eat the most in Kerala?
Paratha.
Barota and that's great. Pardon? Curry chicken.
Yeah.
That's great. So I think there's somebody. Barota is always the biggest thing in Kerala for everyone. So I think it's great that you love it. Marcus, let's talk a little bit about Trinidad and Tobago itself. I know football is a great culture there. You had a 2006, the team went on to the World Cup at that point of time and probably were the smallest country to have reached that level until Iceland qualified last time. How is football in Trinidad and Tobago? Is there a lot of good talent coming up there?
There's a lot of talent. I'm telling you, there are a lot of talent in different communities that haven't even been seen as yet. You know, I can tell you about my place.
Okay.
There's a lot. So think about different other places in Trinidad. There's a lot of talent, I'm telling you. But just have not been established is for people to see what they can do.
No, so so Trinidad also has other sports. I think your mother had been a cricketer herself. How interested are you in cricket?
I'm very interested. I love cricket more than football. That was my first sport. I did not
like it
that much. I was more interested because I'm that good. And you know, it's just my bigger cousins used to take me to the beach, and that's when I developed that love for football.
Okay. So, what kind of cricketer were you? You were a fast bowler. You were a batsman. What were you?
I do everything: bat, bowl, field, wicket keep, everything.
So you are a perfect T20 player.
Yes.
So I'm just thinking that you could have actually played like your counterparts in the IPL for in India, maybe.
Yes. Yes, I would have loved to, just to showcase my talent a little bit and for you guys to see.
But I think Kerala cricket also might need you if Kerala is also a team which wants to establish itself in cricket. So you could do two roles with Kerala.
That wouldn't be a problem, man. I would love to do that.
Great. So there is one question from Navneet Karail who asks you, who is your favorite cricketer?
Brian Lara.
Brian Lara, the ultimate, the legend.
That's my favorite cricketer.
So what makes him so special, Marcus? We know he has scored tons of runs, right? Yeah. But you come from West Indies, which is the larger part. Brian Lara also comes from there. What makes him so special?
That's the way how he moves, the way how he bats. He have a different style, a different, you know, that it's unique. That you don't see this all the time. The way how he plays his shots. That's make him different from everybody else, eh?
Yeah. So, just conclude a conversation on cricket. Is there any player that you like seeing in India? Indian cricket also has stars, superstars, right? Anybody that you love watching?
Yeah, but my best Indian player was Tendulkar.
Yeah.
He was a Tendulkar. Between him and Lara, I think he was the one to give Lara competition.
Right. I mean, I think a lot of Indians may not agree to it, but I think Brian Lara was simply superb. The kind of, like you rightly said, the talent that he had was amazing, and that's great. Let's shift back to football, right? In the current setup in India, right? Are there any footballers that you like seeing? I mean, how is the talent in India that you have seen?
There's a lot of talent, a lot of young talent. Look at the younger players because more the senior players they are done on their way out of football. So you know the younger players they are the future in football. So you know the younger. I have a lot of young players on my team too. So you know they help me to push myself. You know? So more the younger players. There's a lot of talent. Yeah.
But tell me something, Marcus. In India, where do you think are the gaps when you come in terms of playing skills? Where do you think are the gaps?
I think more confidence. They need a lot of more confidence because they can play football. They can do pretty well, but it's just confidence. If they get more confidence, the football in India will be higher.
But in terms of skill that you see, in terms of footballing skills, Do you think Indians are improving in terms of skills to take up the other teams in the world?
A lot. I can mention for my team, Rashid, for instance. Very good,
okay.
Very good vision. Very good mm-hmm. touch on the ball. Good, very good class. I tell mm-hmm. you, the football mm-hmm. is developing. I'm telling you.
Yeah, I think we have lost signals a little bit, but I think it should be fine now. Can you hear me, Marcus?
Yes, I'm hearing you.
Yeah. So, fantastic. So, we talked about Indian football. We talked about, I think there were also questions where somebody wanted to ask you whether you would want to like to go to the ISL. I don't want to get into that topic right now. But I think there is a process where there is a process to have one football set up in the country. I think there is a plan which is set up, and I think we all hope, right, Marcus, that everyone plays in one good league in India, and that is how the country prospers.
Yes, it must. You must have that kind of level of football first division football with a lot of teams, so you know you mm-hmm. play a number of games, and then you mm-hmm. will have your second division there. So you know mm-hmm. every state should have that
sure.
that quality team who they sure. say, well, this is a senior team. You know?
So, Marcus, is there any footballer that you love to see across the globe? Which footballer is somebody who really think is a great player, role model?
Well, my role model, he had stopped playing. My role model is the number 9 from Brazil, Ronaldo. That's my
Ronaldo.
Favorite. I love to see him.
Mm-hmm. Have you ever had a chance to kind of interact with him, play alongside any time?
I have not. He was much older than me. All I do,
okay.
I watch on TV and try to develop his move and
So, one common thing that I'm seeing, Marcus, is all your role models, Brian Lara, Tendulkar, Ronaldo, are all from that era.
World-class players only.
World-class players, right. Fantastic. So, what next for, as a team for Trinidad and Tobago, how is the national team doing and how do you want to, are there any goals for the next 3-4 years?
Yes, there are a lot of goals I set for myself and also mm-hmm. for the Trinidad team.
Mm-hmm.
I would love to get maybe a fair chance mm-hmm. to establish myself to be a first player in the team.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
To at least score a lot of goals for them, to take them to the next level, to take us higher up in the rankings.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
But right now we are not doing so good. So, you know, I would love to get that fair chance to help them to reach where we need to be.
That's fantastic to hear. So, talking about this year's I-League, it was cut short because of the COVID. And we had an eventual winner, in the form of Mohan Bagan. How was the season for Gokulam in this year's I-League? I mean, were you doing well? What was the momentum like?
You know, this season it wasn't that bad. It was mm-hmm. better than last season. You know? Mm-hmm. But I think we could have been even higher in the standings, you know? Maybe get mm-hmm. some. We get. I don't know. They say maybe we got a lot of bad calls mm-hmm. from referees. You know, we scored right. goals, disallowed goals. So, you know,
right.
that's why maybe we are lower in the standing. But I think if we train harder, I don't want to blame anybody, but mm-hmm. to really say that we had also train a little harder, give a little more. In mm-hmm. a sense, we have been mm-hmm. better in the league in the standings right now.
No, perfect. So, getting to the last session, last 5-6 minutes of our interaction, Marcus, the thing I want to ask you is that when do you think football is going to get back to normalcy? I mean, now that the COVID has happened, there is going to be a lot of restriction. What are you hearing? I mean, is football going to be happening this year? What are your views?
The question. Can you repeat?
So with the COVID happening, there's less of football now, and it has to restart someday. So when do you think the earliest football can start?
Well, I can't say because I don't know when this virus is going to stop. So I can't really say. So all I have to do is just wait and see until ready. Yeah.
Right. Let us also talk a little bit about Gokulam as an organization, as a setup. What they do for football, right? So can you let the audience know how Gokulam has really helped the footballing culture around, how it is contributing. Obviously, everyone knows that we have a team. We have an I-League team, we have a women's team. But what else is the support system like in Gokulam?
Well, I think the setup is very good. You know, we have a very good pitch. We have a very good management. You know, the boss, Pravin, he gives a lot. He gives a lot for the team and for the club. So, you know.
Right.
The fans, the people in Kela, you know, they support us a lot. So maybe the management, they love us. They treat us very well. They take care of all our needs. You know. So the setup is very good. It's very good. I can say.
That's nice to hear because I would like to say that management actually has to put in a lot of time, money in teams, and that is how football survives from a larger aspect. So I think that's a great thing that Gokulam FC has been doing. Marcus, also let's talk about nutrition. I mean, nutrition is something which everyone needs. How has been the nutrition for you as a team and football in general? Nutrition, what?
My
nutrition. I mean, the sports drink that you take, the proteins that you take for you know, fast snap included. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I think all the players, we take fast snap. You know, when we go to eat food, fast snap. We always shake up fast snap in our butter before training. While training going on, sometimes we wake up sometimes and. You know, it's fast enough we are drinking because it's pretty good. It gives us a lot of energy. You know, food wise, you know, it's not like home to say like you are on a strictly diet. You know, you always eating vegetables. You are a boiled potato or something. You for yourself need to have a different nutrition.
Right.
When you come out here, because there's a lot of things kind of chew you up once you get accustomed.
Right. So, Marcus, I've come to the end of the show. I just want to ask you a few rapid questions, fire questions, crisp answers. That's all what is required. So, let's go, Marcus, on this. Your favorite footballing moment. What has been your favorite footballing moment?
My favorite footballing moment is when we win games at home with the fans. The way how they cheer us on, I think that's my biggest moment.
Nice. Your favorite holiday destination?
In India? In India, maybe the best I've ever seen is during Easter time, all the lights, all the rockets, all them. Firecrackers and thing, yeah.
Where was that?
Easter time,
okay. That's great. And which is your favorite holiday destination across the world?
Throughout the world? Maybe our culture, carnival time.
Okay, great. That's nice. Are you into any of these Amazon Prime, Netflix? Are you watching any series right now?
No, I don't really watch movies really. You know,
okay.
I'm not a big fan of TV or anything. If I'm watching any television show or anything, it's more like movies from hood, more hood movies.
Right. Any Malayalam movie have you ever seen? Do you know any actors in Malayalam, actresses in Malayalam?
No, I have not watched any movie in Malayalam or anything because, you know, I'm not accustomed with the language, but sometimes my players, they are so interested in these movies,
yeah.
And then I sit and maybe watch a few, maybe 2-3 minutes of them and enjoy to them, yeah.
That's fantastic, Marcus. I think a lot of fans really love you. I mean, they really want, as I see Shamim writes, that stay at Gokulam FC for many years, Marcus. You are our legend. So there are many people who would obviously want Marcus to be at Gokulam FC for whatever time it takes. So that's always there. I would like to thank you for being part of this session. In fact, the fans, I know the fans in Kerala because I grew up in Kerala. So I exactly know how much passion they bring to the table as far as football is concerned. There's also a question, do you speak any Malayalam words? We tried asking Marcus. He probably has to get that back. Footballing comes naturally to him. So thank you, Marcus. You please stay safe. I hope you get back to your family soon and enjoy your time there. I'm sure this is not a great time to be separated. And we all want you to come back home, come back to India, play for Gokulam again. Thank you so much for having you in this session.
Yeah, no problem, man. And I want to say thank you to you and to the fans. I appreciate all the love and all the gifts that I've received from the Kerala people. I thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Marcus. Stay safe. Bye-bye. And love you, Captain. Bye.